There are over 100 different ways to say thank you in the English language alone. The average person uses at least one of these phrases per day as a way to express their appreciation for somebody or something. But most of us aren't aware of the true power of gratitude. While I wouldn't say it has lost its meaning, I think we underestimate its value. What I mean by this is, gratitude can do pretty much anything. Gratitude makes not only ourselves happier, but those around us happier. It can manifest a positive future for ourselves, and it can even cure depression in some cases. Here's a great quote I found while writing this video. Gratitude is the best medicine. It heals your mind, your body, your spirit, and attracts more things to be grateful for. Now, I'm sure there are at least a couple of viewers watching this and going, "But me too, that sounds cool and all, but what do I have to be grateful for?" You know, it's funny you say that because it reminds me of this particular SpongeBob episode. If you're a longtime viewer of mine, you would know that in the past I've talked about how Squidward isn't exactly a good example of a character that should be replicated in real life. As proven in certain episodes, he is a character that bases his happiness primarily around external values rather than internal values. His happiness revolves around validation from other people, his status, and his money. The idea that he can generate happiness through a shift in mindset or perspective doesn't exist to him. He is the epitome of someone with a victim mindset. Not saying everything that happens in life is our fault, but there is a problem that comes with the inability to take accountability and responsibility for our own decisions. According to Squidward, the world hasn't done anything for him, therefore he has nothing to be grateful for. With this mindset, it's no wonder why he attracts so much bad luck into his life. And this episode in particular expresses how this kind of attitude does nothing but cause more suffering for us in the long term. When SpongeBob makes an effort to convince him to change his attitude to gratitude, Squidward denies this possibility.
"Keep your hat and your gratitude, cause being your neighbor leaves me with nothing to be grateful for."
If the dude isn't really in a grateful mood, I can respect that, but the issue comes when he is blaming everyone around him for his misery. As you'll notice throughout this episode, he never takes responsibility for his own emotions.
"SpongeBob, I hate my job, and I live in a dead-end town with neighbors I can't stand. I'm the most miserable person in Bikini Bottom!"
He then asks, what could he possibly be grateful for? SpongeBob tells him one immediate thing to be grateful for is the fact that his life isn't worse than it already is, or more appropriately, seems to be to him. This may seem like a ridiculous thing to be grateful for, but it's the first step to a shift in mindset that gives us a better chance of generating future success. Whenever you are in a situation that feels frustrating or out of your control, it's important to remember it could be worse. Right now, you are currently living someone else's dream life. I know it may not seem like that, but it's the small things that count. A couple of examples that come to mind are family, friends, a bed, a roof to sleep under, reliable sources for food, reliable sources for water, technology, electricity, etc. These things may not seem like much, but when compared to the perspective of someone else in the world, someone who isn't used to them, any one of them would feel like a luxury. It's easy to get so caught up in one area in our life and forget the hundreds, if not thousands, of other blessings that we take for granted. It's easy to say things like, "I'm the most miserable person in my city," but when actually put into the perspective of someone who is actually the most miserable, we'll immediately take that statement back. As the story continues, a volcano in the near distance erupts out of nowhere and burns down the Krusty Krab. Everyone runs for their lives as half the city catches on fire. In the volcano shelter, this dolphin character appears and tells the citizens that in order to save the city, they have to sacrifice the town's most miserable person, aka Squidward Grumpy Tentacles. So moments later, as Squidward is about to be thrown into the volcano, SpongeBob offers to sacrifice himself instead out of the kindness of his heart, but to further emphasize the bad karma that can manifest when one is lacking an attitude of gratitude, he accidentally steps on a ledge that breaks, leaving him hanging on for his life. He begs SpongeBob to help him, but his previous comments about how being his neighbor left him nothing to be grateful for and to never help him ever again has come back to bite him in the you know what. Now he's screwed. He literally has no choice but to contemplate how much his life means to him.
I do appreciate your friendship. I am grateful. I'm grateful for the life I'm living. Who knows how long I'll have it?
One message I took away from the scene is, even in our darkest moments, deep down, we're grateful for something. We may not want to admit it, but it is there, somewhere. And in his final moments, Squidward realizes that even the problems he faces in his daily life is something to be grateful for. There's this quote from Adventure Time that spoke to me. To live life, you need problems. If you get everything you want the minute you want it, what's the point of living? Unfortunately, for many of us, it takes us all the way up until our final hours to realize a good life isn't just the positive experiences. It isn't just the rainbows or just the butterflies. It's also the painful stuff, the moments that piss us off, that confuse us, that makes us wish we lived on a different planet. It's those moments that give us the motivation to help create a new world, a world that appeals to our artistic vision. All of that is what makes life worth living. Without problems, life becomes meaningless. Therefore, it's not about our experience on Earth being good or bad. It's about the experience, period. This confession is real enough to convince SpongeBob to save his life. Now, does Squidward carry this energy with him from this point onward? I'll leave that up for you to guess. It's not that hard to figure out, by the way. There's this quote from John F. Kennedy. As we express our gratitude, we must never forget that the highest appreciation is not to utter words, but to live by them. Human language is limited. Actions speak louder than words. And that's how you can determine whether someone is living with true gratitude or a lower form of gratitude. It's easy to say things like, "Of course I'm grateful," but to actually prove it, to actually express it in a way where people around us can sense that we're grateful without us even saying anything is a different challenge. I feel like people try to undervalue gratitude as if it's not really important. Gratitude isn't just this coping mechanism to escape the painful moments in life. In order to even have emotions in the first place, it requires some form of gratitude. It requires us to care about something. Most of us lock that love away to protect ourselves from potential pain. Therefore, we all have gratitude inside us already. And at that point, I guess it just depends on how joyful you want your life to be. Everyone's life is different. It's really cool if you think about it. There is no right way to live. It's all perspective. Sometimes we get so lost in comparison to other people that we forget the easiest way to win is to love our life the way it is. Thanks for watching. Thank you.